It's been a year since Vadim and I received our iPhone 11 Pros, and in this video, I'll give you our final opinions on arguably Apple's best phones ever. Both what's still fantastic, and also what I didn't expect to end up disappointing me. I'll also touch on things like battery degradation, software, real-world usability, and then focus on how it keeps up with the new competition that came out within this year. For those of you wanting to buy a used or a discounted iPhone 11 Pro instead of a new iPhone 12, I'll let you know if it's worth it or if you'll be wasting money. And I'll say it ahead of time, I'm sorry if I tick off some of the Apple fanboys out there. I've purchased a lot of iPhones over the years, upgrading every year, and the iPhone 11 was probably my favorite update. Honestly, I think it was an even bigger upgrade than going from the 8 to the 10, which was a brand new redesign. With that said, I also think that the 11 Pro might be outdated the fastest. More on this in just a bit. There were two major reasons that really stood out on why I love the iPhone 11. First off, I really enjoyed the new cameras and software. I was stoked that Apple added the ultrawide. Now, I don't use it that often, but when I do, it's at times where I really can't capture the shot with a standard lens or using a panorama, so it's very nice to have. The telephoto lens got improved low light performance with a new sensor and the f2.0 aperture, and it made me use it much more often. And the bigger addition is that I was able to take portrait photos with a wide lens, which results in great low light and a very cool looking perspective, which is something that I asked for in my iPhone XS review. There were also tons of improvements on the software side. For photos, Apple added more contrast, which I really prefer, the dynamic range got better at the same time, and diffusion made a big impact for medium lighting situations. Video quality was also fantastic with great improvements like video stabilization and much more. Now, unfortunately, Apple's lead at launch, which was massive, didn't last as long as I expected. The second and probably the biggest reason was the battery life. Seemingly, for the first time ever, Apple actually listened to many people's complaints and made a phone that was thicker in order to improve the battery life, and boy did it get better. The roughly 25% larger battery paired with the more efficient and improved A13 processor was a game changer in battery life. I no longer had to top off my phone during the middle of the day, and most nights when I plugged in my phone to charge, it was at about 30% of battery. Now, this might not seem to be a huge deal, but in reality, this was probably the biggest change in real-world phone usage ever. No longer did I have to worry about always having a charger cable with me or a power bank, and if I forgot to plug my phone in at night, I wouldn't wake up to it being dead in the morning. For Vadim, the difference was even bigger. With his XS, he would limit his display brightness in order to save battery life, and a lot of the time he would set his phone to battery saver mode in order to get through the day. With the 11 Pro, none of that is required now, and he doesn't even charge his phone nightly. When he's at the office, he keeps it on the wireless charger, and that's it. Now, with the way better battery life, the 11 Pro also got a fast charger in the box, which was kind of weird because for most people, it's not really needed now. Apple probably should have included it with the iPhone X or the XS instead. My 11 Pro can charge to 50% in 30 minutes instead of taking about 1.5 hours, which is a massive difference. This extra wattage also means more heat, so I decided to take a look at my battery health, and just as I expected, it's not great. After 1 year with the XS Max, my battery had 94% of life remaining, and my 11 Pro Max after 1 year is showing 89%. I suspect that this is because of me using that fast charger instead of using the slow 5-watt charger at night. Now, if you're somebody that wants their 11 Pro to last, say, 3 to maybe even 5 years and still maintain a full day's charge, I would suggest finding that old 5-watt charger and using it if you're the person that charges nightly instead of using this fast charger. Now let's move on to my 3 other disappointments after 1 year. One thing that I was skeptical about is that the RAM stayed at the same 4 GB as the iPhone XS. Now, as time went on, this annoyed me more and more. The XS seemed to be okay at 4 GB when the competition had 6 or 8 GB, but now phones like the Note 20 have 12 or even 16, and the difference is definitely noticeable. Yes, iOS is more efficient, but at the same time, the camera app uses a ton of memory because Apple shows you the HDR and even the portrait mode shots in real time, which takes a ton of processing compared to the fake blur on Samsung phones, or even nothing being visible on Pixel phones and just being done afterwards. As time went on, I got more and more annoyed with not only having to reload apps I recently used, but some apps, for example, Facebook or YouTube, would actually close if I open my phone app and I take a few photos, and then going back into Facebook, having to retype a post or a comment or find a video that I was just going to open in YouTube. This was made worse when I spent time with the S20 or the Note 20, and they not only didn't have these issues, but literally I could reopen apps from the day before and they would still be saved exactly how I left them. Now, if Apple allowed me to pay more to get, say, 6 or 8 gigs on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, I absolutely would. Now, the second major issue that I wasn't expecting was the LTE speeds. Apple has been behind compared to Qualcomm modems for a while now, but this year it is even more noticeable than ever. We don't even have ultra-fast 5G here, just sub-6, but the difference is massive. If you've only used iPhones over the years, you might not know the difference, but as somebody that uses both a newer Android and the iPhones, the Android runs about 5 times faster, and the difference isn't just in downloads, but by how fast pages load, and probably the biggest noticeable difference is streaming video, where I usually can't even play back at 1080p without tons of buffering and issues on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, but the Samsung, at the same location at the same time, plays back 1440p perfectly. My biggest concern is how this will age the iPhone 11 Pro in the next few years, since the speed difference will be so massive compared to the iPhone 12 Pro, which should finally have much better modems, including 5G. My last complaint a year later, which is completely surprising, is the camera performance. A year ago, it was top-notch, but the competition is moving so fast that Apple can't stay on top like they used to. Zoom photos look dramatically better on a new Samsung and even on cheaper Pixel phones, and my biggest issue looking into the future is that Apple won't allow night mode shots with anything but the main sensor. We know that this can be done with software, since the Pixel 4a uses its inferior front-facing camera to take much better nighttime photos than the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And Samsung's ultra-wide and telephoto night shots look so much better than the iPhone 11 Pros. Now don't get me wrong, the iPhone 11 Pro was a fantastic top-of-the-line phone when it came out, and a year later it is still a great phone. But I feel like, even though it's my favorite iPhone update, this year has been the toughest on an iPhone with so much tech moving forward so fast, and the competition is improving just a ton in just one short year, that this phone is gonna be aging the fastest from any other iPhones. In the past, you can buy an iPhone X instead of buying a XS and you could save some money, and sure, it would run a little bit slower and the photos were a little bit worse, but the difference wasn't that big. This time around, once the iPhone 12 comes out, there will be massive improvements in photo capabilities, RAM will be much better, data speeds will be much faster, and the phone will have a huge redesign, so it'll be way more future-proofed for the next 3, 4, 5 years compared to this phone. Let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. How did the iPhone 11 Pro age in your mind, and how is it doing compared to the competition? We'll be covering the iPhone 12 here in just a few days with some great comparisons and reviews, so click that circle above to subscribe. If you want to see the latest huge leaks, watch that video right over there. Thank you guys for watching. This has been Max, and I'll see you in the next video.